shoot into Cape Runaway. Just gonna tuck away out of this little swell we got here and chuck our three spear fishermen in the water.
Well, with the fish not exactly biting, but this beautiful clear blue water and close to the coast, I decided to get this and come for a swim around Cape Runaway. We know there's big kingies here, big bronze whaler sharks, and we're gonna go in for a look. But we're not going completely unarmed. Nat and Rochelle are gun spear fishermen. Oh, fishers, fisher people. And I'm just gonna do my best to keep up with them and well, we're gonna see what we can see. Hopefully I'll be good enough to get it all on here.
The warm blue water has pushed right into the coast, which means we've got great visibility. And already, we can see snapper cruising around. It's not often you get to see snapper in conditions like this, so we're enjoying just checking them out until the right fish comes along to take a shot at.
Look at those kingies, massive kingies down there.
And this could be our chance. Once again, we first go down to investigate, only this time, Rochelle is ready to take a shot if the opportunity presents. And here it is. A big kingfish cruises into range.
It's a beast!
Oh, f***! Float!
The big, powerful kingfish is dragging Rochelle through the water, so she frantically adds another float to her line to try and slow it down. And amidst the chaos, her float lines have become entangled around her head and neck. With the lines cleared and danger averted, the focus goes back on keeping this big brute away from the reef, where it could get into the rocks and easily break the shooting line or break the spear itself. But hauling on the line too hard may cause the spear to tear out, and we can see it's starting to tear already. So we have some anxious moments as we're frantically trying to organise another gun to secure the fish with a second shot.
The other gun.
Rochelle goes down, takes careful aim, and this time, it's a good holding shot.
We got it now, boy! We got it now!
The fish is secure, but in a place like this, sharks will have almost certainly detected the commotion or smelled the blood. So we need to get it under control and back to the boat.
Left
on
that arm, ice
box.
Yep.
Oh my god, that's a
problem. Nice kingy. Well, that was a bit more exciting than looking at marlin lures. Well, hold on.
Oh, man.
That was one hell of a fish.
Now, of course, Rochelle's kingy grabs all the attention from that dive. But one of the things that I'm blown away from is just all of the big snapper that I saw. Right from when we dropped in the water under the boat, there was snapper mid-water in crystal clear blue water, something I've never seen before. So we've altered our plan ever so slightly. Nat stayed in the water, he's looking for our parwa and crayfish for dinner. And while we're waiting for him to come back, I've rummaged around, grabbed some of our Southern Baits burley, and it's going to be an impromptu snapper burley session. Now Nat's getting on out there. Hopefully he's doing better than us. These snapper, I can't even see a snapper anymore. They're gone.
Shark here.
Is there?
I just gave the shark a try.
Oh, really? Did you have your head cam rolling?
Run out of battery.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Did you shoot it?
What was he, bronzy?
A white.
A white? What? Great white? A great white?
Yeah, that's what he was just on the other side and he come back and then I shot him just under the boat here because he kept getting a bit friendly.
And your head, Kim, wasn't run out of battery?
Battery's flat.
No! That was right where we speared the kingfish.
Right where we speared the kingfish, right on the rock.
It was a white.
A white, definitely.
That'll be why the snapper aren't biting.
There's nothing there.
I know, mate. Like, we were just saying, maybe the fish aren't biting, all those snapper we saw. You know, and like, we could see them in the burley at first, and then everything just disappeared.
Yeah.
Holy!
Yeah, it was just a long swim from the other side of the rock back to here.
Oh, bro, you should have waved out.
So, oh. Yeah, it was alright, the water was clear.
Oh. Oh well, I should be happy that Nat's back in one piece. Not gutted that the GoPro battery run flat. Oh, here, anyway, craze and power. See, now a good thing about all of that is that at least the craze and power were attached to the float. So had Nat got smoked by the white shark, well, you still would have got the craze and powers back.
I gave it a jab on the other side of the rock there when it swam up to me. And really? Gave him a good jab in the face, and then he came back to me here and I just shot him in the back and like just in the tail.
After a couple of big days and big nights out on the open ocean, tonight we're in the sanctuary of a sheltered bay and we're celebrating the fact that we still have a full crew with a nice fresh seafood meal. Because in the morning we've got a lot more ground to cover and plenty more fish to catch.